Here we are. We are a couple of minutes late today, Sabrina. And it's a very intimate webinar today. Actually, it will be myself and Sabrina that I'm going to introduce soon. But while the people are landing in the webinar, I want to start saying that this is our last webinar with the sustainability talk series with the Sustainable Talks with NNN. It's our last dance for this event. And we want to thank everybody and Linea Pelle to give us the opportunity to have this informative and deep webinars. So some housekeeping rules. We are gonna go through some presentations. Sabrina is gonna go introduce us about the work of eCheck, and I'm gonna do some question here and there where we find something interesting part. But you can also add your question in the Q&A section. Please try to be short and focus on the point that's easier to read and to make the question to Sabrina. It's also easier for her to answer to the question. And then we try to answer all the questions. The one that we will not be able to answer, we will reply. Unich will reply on it. So Unich is very good actually on replying on very professional questions on this. And then I'm part of Sustainable Talks with NNN, with my friend Nicolo Durante in New York. I'm in Amsterdam, and we aim to bring awareness in the fashion business, in the supply chain of the fashion industry. So we'll do this through interview of CEO of Tanneries, Mill, Sustainable Association, NGO, designers, teacher, and all the peers that we find are doing impact in the sustainability in the fashion industry. So if you're also passionate about sustainability and about fashion, then please join us and follow us as a Sustainable Talks with NNN. But then I speak already a lot and a bit too much. I want to start introducing Sabrina Fontoni from eCheck, the Institute of Quality Certification for the Leather Sector. And she's the director of eCheck. As all of us, she's passionate about fashion and leather. And I want to ask you, Sabrina, what about your passion of sustainability? What is sustainability for you, Sabrina?
Hello, everyone. And thank you, Nicolo, for your kind introduction. And thanks to Linea Pelle also for this opportunity to show our vision of sustainability. Let's start from your question. And sustainability for me is really a way of daily behavior. 20 years of activities, I always try to move this principle in my way of work. And that's why I'm always engaged in the development of standards and the certification on this topic. But I think that today we have time, and I'll show you in my presentation any detail of my passion in sustainability.
That's great. That's a great start, Sabrina. Thanks a lot. Every time we have different interpretation of sustainability, it's very difficult to define this word that is maybe a little bit abused. But we can start with the presentation. We can start showing the presentation of today that will be about certification. And Sabrina, maybe you want to start, tell us a little bit of basic about certification and eCheck, what eCheck is doing.
Yes, I created this presentation through slides, and I hope they will help all of us to follow in the best way my talk. Let me say something to introduce eCheck, because it's important. It's my Institute of Certification. ICEC is the quality certification institute that works worldwide and only in the leather sector. We have 25 years of activities, and we work under accreditation. It's very important to guarantee competence, confidentiality, and no conflicts of interest. We release voluntary certifications. third type. This means that, first of all, there is no obligation to do our certification. We are independent from the company which is audited, and we ensure also the confidentiality of the data that we see during the audit. This is very important because many of the information that we see are sensitive from a commercial point of view. So I think that working in this way is a good way to work and to give credible guarantees on sustainability. Let's go with the other slide, please. So I want to give you some numbers about our activities. We have more than 350 certificates, more than 150 certified companies. About 95 of them are in Italy. All the others are in extra European or European countries. We have a lot of certification in Italy because Italy provides more or less 65% of the leather in Europe and 25% of leather worldwide. This is the reason why we have so many tanneries certified here in our country. And we certify all the supply chain. You have to consider that we certify not only tanneries, but also brand manufacturers, subcontractors, traders, and chemical suppliers. And
Sabina, as I told before, yes. Sorry to interrupt you. I just see here the country where you do have a certification. I wanted to ask you, I mean, there is also a lot of tanneries in Asia, for example, but there is not certification there. Can you please give it? Tell us why it's not certificating in Asia, or we don't have certification in Asia?
We have certification not only in Italy, but also in Europe and in extra European countries. As you can see in this slide, we did certification in Serbia, in Tunisia, in Turkey, in Spain, Netherlands. About Asia, I can say that the topic of certification and sustainability are international. So both in Europe, in Asia, in America, or in many other countries, you have to deal with the qualification of the supply chain in every country. And every country can choose among different kinds of certification. The scheme that the e-check will show you are the most applicable. For example, the ISO standard are not regional, but are international standard. So also in Asia, we will have many tanneries certified, for example, according to ISO 14001, 9001. So it's not real that they don't have certification, they have it. But each shall release our its services in any countries on request, and we move when they ask us to give our services of certification. So we are based in Milan, but we can work worldwide. And remember that the certification are applied worldwide, especially if they are international standard.
Clear. And I see, sorry, Sabrina, before to go ahead, I just see a lot of questions coming on. I just want to point a few ones. So Philippa Grogan is asking if there is a recording and is shared. Yes, this episode will be recorded and shared through the email, and it will be in YouTube. And then also we have a question from Jerome Dodmal. Can you please talk about certification to check in relation to eco leather material, example, chrome-free tan leather and leather alternative as well, vegan leather alternatives? It's when we hear vegan leather, it's really difficult to understand what it is, because there's no leather, there's no vegan without leather. I mean, it's or leather or vegan, you know? But maybe we can go later on this, Sabrina.
Yes, sure, because there is a little section of this presentation dedicated to the topic of eco-leather. What I can say now that with the term eco-leather, we cannot intend synthetic or textile or vegetable leather, because there are laws protecting the right use of the terms. So in a few minutes, we will see how we can measure the real eco-leather. which are real leather produced with a low environmental impact. And for sure, when we speak about eco leather, we don't mean only vegetable tanned leather, but also chromium tanned leather and with other kinds of tanning process. But let me show you some details soon after my presentation.
Okay, that's great. That's maybe on this topic, the last one I see from Fred van der Put. Do I understand correctly that there are 350 different type of certification, right?
No, the 350 are the number of certificates released on different kinds of schemes, but we don't have 350.
There will be too much, too many.
There will be too much. This is the number of certificates that we released.
Okay,
there are not 350 kinds of different certifications. Yeah.
Okay, then sorry.
We
can go ahead.
So we can go on with the next slide. If you are interested to know why sustainability, because it's necessary and it's required for commercial reasons for sure, because many consumers are focused on buying sustainable products and companies have to give them guarantees on this. But sustainability is done also for risk management reasons. Because if you sell something, you have to be aware of what happens inside your company and in all your supply chain, including subcontractors. So these are all the reasons why you can do sustainability and have sustainable products. Right, please. For sure, sustainability doesn't come for free. It's important to say that there is a cost, and the annual report released by UNICH, UNICH is the Italian National Tanners Association, says that the average cost for an Italian tannery to be sustainable is more or less 5% of the annual revenue. This means that if you want a sustainable product, you have to pay a little bit more because you have to do a lot of compliance with sustainable topics, and it means that you have to invest people, invest in many sustainable processes, and at the end, so you have to pay a little bit more to have sustainable products.
Right. And why we need then to pay more? Why we need sustainability? Why we need to pay more to have sustainability?
Sabrina. Because everything you do has a cost. Not only certification, but beyond certification, if you want to produce a sustainable product, you have to do research and development, you have to invest in new technologies. And so all these activities are not for free. Okay, I try to be short in my answer because I think that there will be a lot of questions. So I try to
It's be great. Short.
Okay. So the components of sustainability, as you can see in these slides, we have three areas: the environmental, the social, and the economic ones. So to be sustainable means to deal with all these three areas. And in each area, we have some topics. For example, in the environmental one, we have to deal with all the impacts that the company has during the production, for example, is related to water, atmospheric emission, consumption of resources, and so on. In the social one, we have requirements linked to human resources, health and safety in the workplaces. And in the economic area, we have traceability, transparency, animal welfare issues. And so for each topic, we will have a specific certification. Next slide. You may ask how we can provide credible guarantees on this topic. And the answer is that for sure, sustainability can be verified and certified. Next. I want to add that, first of all, sustainability comes from the observance of national and regional laws. It's very important because it's great if they are strict and well controlled. For example, here in Europe, we really have enforced laws for environment, for health and safety, for workers. So you have a sort of common sustainability, which is guaranteed by laws. Next slide. And beyond laws, there is the application of voluntary certification, which are released by bodies of certification of third parties, as the Czech is. This means, as I told you before, that these body of certifications are independent from the audited companies. Next. I would like to spend 2 minutes to show you some preliminary concepts about certification, also because we have more than 400 attendees. So I want really to speak 2 minutes to give you some preliminary concepts. To release a voluntary certification means that an independent and qualified body of certification makes an audit and certifies that an organization or a product is compliant to the requirements of an official standard or of an official protocol. Next, we can have two main different kinds of certification. You can have the system certification, through which the organization of the company is certified according to management system standard, which can cover, for example, environmental, social, or health and safety topics. Or you can have product certification, through which the leathers or the leather goods are certified according to product standard. For example, we can test chemicals, physical, fastness, origin, traceability, characteristics of leather or of the leather goods. Next. The certification is released according to a standard. It shall be a national standard, an international one. For example, UNI means that the standard is Italian. CEN is the European body of standardization. ISO is the International Standardization Organization, and this means that the standard is international. When there is
does this mean that the certification of ESEC, let's say the standard, are coming from these three organizations?
They are coming from these three organizations, but not only from these three organizations, because when there is a lack of standard, the sector shall apply also private standard to fill some specific issues. That's why, for example, we created the technical specification, for example, for traceability or chemical topics. In fact, when I will list all the certifications, you will see some of them are ISO, UNI, and standard. Others can be ECHTS technical specifications.
So basically, a tannery could be certified ISO, but not enough to be certified IEC.
Exactly. And when you decide to be certified by ISO standard, ECHTS is not only the only body of certification worldwide. You have a lot of body of certification accredited to release ISO standard certification. So we really have a lot of competitors worldwide. Next slide. Another key point is the accreditation. ECHEC is accredited by Accredia, which is the national body of accreditation. And this means that our entire process of issuing certification is constantly checked to guarantee that we work in a competent way. And this is really a strength point for us and a guarantee of reliability for our customers to be accredited. Next.
Sabrina, sorry to interrupt again.
No problem. I know that is a talk, so you can interrupt me.
No, because you said You said there is UNICE is not the only one, the only certification body. There are other certification
bodies. ICEC, not UNICE, because UNICE is the Tanners Association. ICEC is the body of certification.
And Maria Cox. Yeah, Maria Cox indeed is asking: does ICEC have a partnership or interaction with the leather working group?
We have a dialogue with them. We know that we work on the same topic. And when you say leather working group, for me, is not only an alternative platform of work, because if you are inside the sustainability topics, you know that there are a lot of private initiatives. There is leather working group, there is textile exchange, sustainable leather foundation, there is Ecotex, there is UNECE, CSCB, so really a lot of platforms. We work on the same topic, but we work in a different way, with different standards, with different protocol, and with many of them we have dialogue. Dialogue, and also we try to speak about the possibility to simplify the audit when there are some other standards already applied. So there are a lot of discussion, and there is always the aim to simplify the work of the body of certification when there is something already applied. So we don't have a really collaboration because we are a competitor, but for sure we have dialogue. And recently, for example, we released the certification of the code of conduct of for the Italian tanneries, and we gave to leather working group the contents of this document, and they approved this standard in their protocol, in the social part, as a standard recognized by them. And so the tannery can skip the social audit because they have this code of conduct released by UNICE and controlled by ICEC, the social area is covered. So there are a lot of topics on which we are having dialogue and trying to find a common solution that can be helpful for the leather sector.
That's great. Thank you a lot, Sabrina.
Thank you. So, the certified Italian tanneries are more than 60% of the national tanning turnover, and 75% of these in number are certified with our Institute of Certification. I recommend that to see the names of all the certified companies, please have a look to our database in our website, because it's not possible for me today to give all the names of the certified companies, and it's not polite to mention only some of them. So if you are interested in knowing the names of the tanneries or the brands or the manufacturers certified, please have a look to the official database in our website. Next. So we spoke about sustainability. We have three areas of sustainability. The first one is the environmental one. And let me show you, according to our experience, some of the main certification applicable in this area, giving you some focus on the most particular. Next. The standard ISO 14001 is the International Environmental Management System, which is for sure one of the most applied. 60% of the certified tanneries in Italy have this certification. It can be released by accredited bodies of certification, so not only ICEC, but other bodies of certification. It's a standard applied not only in Italy, but as I told before, worldwide, because it's international, it's an ISO standard. The standard IMAS 3 is an European standard which provides a complete environmental declaration related to the company. And it's something more than ISO 14001. And then if you want to calculate the environmental impacts allocating them to specific leather produced, you can apply the standard UNI 11427, which is related to ecological leathers. So that's the topic that someone asked before. So now I can spend 1 minute to in the next slide to say something about eco leather. Next.
Yes, please.
Okay, so first of all, you have to pay attention because on the market there are many synthetic or vegetable or textile materials that look like leather, but they are not real leather. And all these materials that want to imitate leather cannot be called leather. In many countries, you have laws protecting the right use of the term leather. For example, in Italy, we have the law number 68 released the last year, 2020. So we have to remember that all these alternative materials cannot be called leather and cannot be called eco leather. Next. If you want to know if the real eco leather exists, the answer is yes, eco leather exists, but they are only real leather produced with low environmental impact. And to certify this leather, we have a national standard, UNI 11427. This certification is applicable to any kinds of leather produced with chrome or vegetable or other types of tanning. Okay, this is very important. So you can have eco leather with all kinds of tanning processes. It includes, this standard includes the compliance to low environmental impacts and also requirements for long lasting characteristic of the leather.
So basically, Sabrina, you're saying that eco pelle, eco leather, it means that is a more sustainable certification based on this UNI protocol. But what does exactly mean in a practical? Is the use of less water? Is the use of less chemical? Or
inside this standard, you have some technicals table in which there are some limitations related to environmental impacts. So when you produce your leather, you have to respect these kinds of limitations. They are related to, for example, consumption of water, discharge of water, use of chemicals, and there are some limits. And so you have to, when we do an audit according to this standard, we verify that these limitations are respected, not only because the long lasting of the leathers is another requirement. This means that the finished leather are tested in laboratories to guarantee the quality performances, because you cannot have an ecological leather if it has not a good quality. And so if you have to waste it, it's important to have a leather that has a good level of quality from a physical and fastness point of view. Okay, this is so an environmental product certification. So what you do inside your tannery is allocated to the specific leather, to the unit of measurement of the leather. So for example, square meter or kilogrammos. And you have to consider it to respect these limitations, which are related to this kind of measurement of the leather. It's a national standard. Now is going to be updated, and probably in the near future, we will discuss it also in a European body of standardization, because we don't want it only in Italy, but we would like to have it as a European standard. So we are going to develop it in this way.
That's great. So that means that while eCheck is certifying the process and the tannery, Ecopelle, Ecoleather is a certification of the actual product, no? Of the actual material.
Exactly, exactly. And it's really very requested by many brands, this kind of certification, because the environmental topic is always a focus for brands. They started asking the ISO 14001 as a standard of qualification for environmental topics in the companies. But now they are moving to this kind of standard because they want to know the impact related to the leathers that they are buying from the tanneries. So this standard is more specific to what you are purchasing from the tannery. So it's really appreciated by brands.
And one more question we have from Maximilian Enkelke. Does eCheck only certify tanners or also rawhide traders?
No, we certify also traders. It depends on the schemes of certification, because when I say that we can certify every company in the supply chain, you have to consider that there are specific standards which are applicable to tanneries. For example, this one, the Ecoleather, is applicable only to tanneries because you have to control the tanning phases of production, so you cannot apply it to a trader. But there are many other certifications which are applicable to traders. So for sure, we certify also traders, tanneries, brands, subcontractors, and the different kinds of certification are specific for them.
Great. Thank you, Sabrina.
Thank you. So we can go on. Next slide. In the second area of sustainability, the social and ethical one, let me show, as usual, the main certification. Next slide. All of these certifications are system ones. They are not product ones, because they shall be related to all the workers employed in a company, with no exclusion. So they are system certification. The ISO 45001 is the most applied to keep guarantees on occupational health and safety in the workplace. And then on social topics, companies shall apply, for example, the social accountability standard SA8000, or they can apply national codes of conduct. Next. In Italy, the National Tanners Association has released a code of conduct for tanneries. It's certified by eCheck, and it includes all the contents of SA8000 and other requirements concerning the protection of worker rights. It requires the involvement of suppliers, the involvement of subcontractors. And as I told before, this standard has been recently approved by LWG to cover the social section of their protocol. Next, the last area is the economic and product one. Let me show the certification. Next. One of the most applied certification in any sector, really in any sector, and also in the leather sector, is the quality management system certification according to ISO 9001 standard. While from a product point of view, we have different choices. We can certify leathers, for example, according to their physical or chemical characteristics, doing tests in laboratories, or for the origin of the raw material, which is traceability, or you can have a product certification related to the origin of the tanning phases of production, which is the main. And I would like to have a focus on this last certification.
Yes, actually we have a question from Giorgia Giabardo. eCheck certifies traceability. Is there certification confirming that leather does not come from animals raised in area linked to the Amazon deforestation in South America?
Okay, Next slide, so I can tell you something more about traceability, because 2 weeks ago, we had a specific webinar on this topic, on the topic of traceability of raw material. And we explained that with our standard of certification, EHEC-TS 410, 412, with us EHEC specification for traceability, we check the origin of the raw or semi-finished hidden schemes related to countries and places of slaughtering and breeding of the animal. For sure, the goal of the customer when they want traceability, for example, can be to ensure animal welfare or to avoid areas with critical environmental issues. In fact, in the webinar, we explained that we have a partnership with some partners, Brazilian and American partners, like CSCB, like NWF, which is National Wildlife Federation, because we have a specific version of these schemes of traceability certification related to the origin, the Brazilian origin of leather. And this certification is called the DCFL, Deforestation and Conversion Free Leathers. But now I think that it's not a good idea to repeat again all the concepts. I think that if between among the attendees there are people interested in the topic of traceability, it's a good idea to see the recording of the past webinar, because we had 1 hour of conversation on this, also with some guests that was related to NWF and with the deforestation. So for sure, we deal with this topic, we have a partnership, we have a specific certification, but now I don't want to repeat everything. Please, let's have a look to the recording of the webinar we had 2 weeks ago.
Yes, great. And just related to this, we have Mariel Catacora that asked, does EHEC can certify in South America, consider that the product will stay in South America?
Sorry, as I told you before, our standards are applicable where you want. The fact that someone in South America, in Asia, can pull EHEC, sometimes it's only an economic problem, because we have to move and they have to pay our auditor to move there. And so it shall be a little bit expensive, okay? It's only an economic consideration that a tannery or another subject have to do. So it's not a problem to move. We can apply our certification, as I told you before, in Italy, in Europe, in extra European country, we can move. If they pay us, we can move worldwide to have this kind of certification. So also in South America or in another country.
And as far as you know, Sabrina, I mean, not to, maybe there are competitors or I don't know, but who can be the or a certification company that certify in South America? Because of course, to pay the transfer to all the South America maybe is too expensive. So if a tannery in South America want to be certified, what will you suggest as economic, let's say economic?
I try to do this name because they are our partners. So for me, it's not polite to do other names and to promote one or other entities of certification. But surely in South America, we have CSCB, which is one of the main certification body. They have a protocol released for sustainability of the tannery, and they cover environmental, social issues and traceability issues. So I think that you can refer to their protocol if you want to be certified there with the body which is there, South America.
Great.
They
great.
Are Brazilian.
Thank you, Sabrina.
So next slide. About made in Italy, made in France, made in Spain. What about this kind of standard? If a tannery wants to declare the made in of the leather, It is related to the substantial transformation processes of the leathers, which are at least the retanning, fat liquoring, and dyeing. They are the substantial transformation phases. For example, if these phases are done in Italy, the leather is made in Italy. But it's an European standard, the EN 16484. It is the one applied to verify these geographical origins and to give the made in to the leather. So with this panoramic, I gave you all the information of all our services of certification. And now I want to make my conclusion with the next slides, talking about the certification of sustainability. So at the end of this presentation, of this talk, we can assure that sustainability can be certified. We have to cover all the three areas because we cannot be sustainable if we work only in one area, but we have to cover all the three areas. So for us, if the company adopts at least one of the standards certified by ECHEC for each of the three areas of sustainability that we have seen, it obtains the certification of the sustainability for the company. Now, more than 30 Italian companies have this kind of award, and these are expected to double within the end of this year because there are a lot of tanneries work to have sustainable award.
Sabrina, is there a different grade of certification or just you are certified or not? Like you pass or you don't pass?
It depends on certification. If you, with this question, you mean if the final result of a certification is pass or not pass, or if it is a final rating, depends on certification. For example, for all the ISO, UNI and ISO standard, there is not a final rating. They are international standard, so all the stakeholders decided that the final result is to pass or not to pass according to the requirements of that standard. For example, there are other schemes of certification, for example, CE71, which is related to a final rating. And also in this case, I spoke 2 weeks ago about the way of collecting data to have this kind of certification. We collect 2 to 12 months of purchase order. We have a mathematical model through which we collect this kind of data and we verify them. And at the end, we have an average and a final rating, which is released and related to the information that you have related to the places or country of origin, of breeding and slaughtering of the animals. So this is an example of certification, which is related to a final rating.
Okay, so there is a score at the end that we can...
For this specific certification, while for many others, there is not a score.
Clear.
And so to end my talk, if you want to see the names of the sustainable company, as usual, you have to have a look in our database. And with this logo that you can see in the slides, you have to understand that we always promote our certified and sustainable tannery. Also, for example, during the fair, during the Belle Fair, there are a lot of tanneries exhibiting which show this logo and their sustainability. So for us, it's important to explain the contents of this logo because someone is not, sometimes it's not so simple to understand the meaning of a lot of logo and certification. So thank you again for this opportunity for us to show you the context of our work.
Yeah, we really miss Linea Pelle, Sabrina. We really miss Linea Pelle. We are looking forward for hopefully next autumn. And I will check it out, this logo that you're showing us as a certification of ECHEC. And we still have a few more questions before to conclude. And I think one is regarding the Made in Italy that you just mentioned a couple of slides ago. So it's Maximilian Engle again, would you declare leather made in Italy if the wet blue come from South America and retanning was made in Italy?
Yes. In fact, the substantial phases on transformation don't include the process of tanning. So if you buy a wet blue or a wet white semi-finished leather, you can process it in Italy and you have a made in Italy leather. Yes. So it is not important when the phases of tanning were done and are not important also the origin of the animals in the made in Italy. So it's only a question of substantial phases of transformation, that liquoring, dyeing, and retanning and finishing. They are done in Italy, in Spain, the leather will be made in Italy, made in Spain or the countries. Okay.
But if we have crust and we only do the finishing in Italy,
no,
in that case,
it's not sufficient. The crust doing only the finishing is not sufficient. You have to retan it if you want to give the made in Italy. And the only the finishing is not sufficient.
One more question from Antonella Antonelli. Hi everyone, is it possible the which way to certify the companies that operate in the sector, even if they are not tanneries, for example, commercial companies that purchase raw material, make them work in tanneries and finally sell them to final customers? So commercial companies, is it possible to certify commercial company?
Yes, as I told before, commercial traders can be certified, but not all the standards are applicable to them. For sure, the ISO standards are applicable to any kinds of sector and any kinds of companies. So 9001, the quality one, the environmental one, which is 14001, the health and safety one, 45001. All these ISO standards, for example, are applicable to traders. Or another kind of certification applicable to them is the traceability certification, because traders can sell, for example, raw materials, semi-finished hides, if they are able to have information about the origin of the animals and all every data we spoke about traceability, they can be certified. And it's very important because sometimes the tannery that buys from them need to have a rating and the traceability is certified from these suppliers. So we have different traders certified according to each traceability standard.
Okay, that's great. No, thanks a lot, Sabrina. And I have one more question that I know that is related to a webinar we had a couple of weeks ago, but I think is also very important about traceability. Will we ever be able to trace a leather to the farm, in your opinion, your personal opinion?
No, it's already possible. It's not so simple, but it's already possible because our traceability schemes collect data from the raw materials to the name of the farms. The mathematical model collects every kind of information. So you already can introduce the information of the country and places of breeding of the animals. If you have them, that's the problem, because it's not so simple to have this name. Also because the tannery does a bottom-up work of traceability. But pushing the supply chain from many well-organized supply chain, especially in the meat industry, we can have these names of the breeding companies. So it's absolutely possible. We have to work a lot on this, and we are working on this topic of traceability, especially in an important project made in UNECE. UNECE is the economic institution in Europe that deals with traders' topics. And we are following with them a traceability program and project which is extended worldwide. And so we hope that we can have a really good improvement following these international programs. And also our schemes of certification will improve, adding in the future some consideration about animal welfare that we are now studying with a few partners, because we know that our scheme of certification related traceability have to develop and have to develop to give more information related to the condition of the animal welfare, the prestation of many other social and critical issues.
So it's still complex and still so expensive to do that, but it is possible going forward.
It's possible, and as I told in the previous webinar, the good situation will have a better situation if we will have a traceability not bottom up, but top down. So if the meat industry will help us in having leather traced, we will receive raw material traced with, for example, numbers or code that can tell us the history of the animals and all the information that we need. So to do traceability top down is really probably more simple than to try to build it bottom up, as we are doing now, starting from the tannery and trying to recreate and rebuild all the what happens in all the supply chain.
So there need to be the full supply chain, starting from the food that required that. Because if I'm not wrong, we were mentioning also last time the fresh meat it needs to have certification of the country of origin. But if it's a processed meat like a salami or whatever, or
yes,
then you don't need to have that. And
you don't need to have
prosciutto made in Italy, but that is coming from, I don't know, Spain or Germany.
Exactly, and you have to deal with the fact that this information, if they are related to meat, as you told before, there is an obligation to give this information with the meat, but not with leather. So another time you have to pay if you want that someone gives you this information. So there is the economic problem, and also there is the problem related to the sensitivity of this information from a commercial point of view. It's not so simple to have this information. But the important is that if you have them, you can verify them and you can start to give guarantees. So you have to start. We started many years ago, and now we have more or less 100 tanneries certified according to traceability scheme. So it's a good result after a few years of work.
Great, great. And to reply to Grame Drake, she's asking where to find the traceability webinar. You can find all the webinar registration in the Linea Pelle website. You go on the Linea Pelle website, there is sustainability talks. And then if you link in, there is all the episode we did, all the 7 episode, the event that we did together, and you can click on all of them and watch the video that is in YouTube. So that's the best, the easiest way to find it. It's very well organized. When you go in the Linea Pelle website, you will find it. And one last question on certification. I see, it's not very specific. I don't know if you can reply to that question, but Nicolò Cafaz is asking, what do you think about UDI and ISO 14021:2016? I don't know if it's...
Sorry, can you repeat?
What do you think about UDI and ISO 14021 from 2016? Nicolò, if you have more detail, please share with us, because it's not easy.
No, because they are environmental standard, but it's very specific issues now to be explained. So I'm please, if someone of the attendees can want to make questions really technical question and specific one, I can write to our email and I can reply you as soon as possible. Because today is very difficult to be really exhaustive on all the schemes of certification. I try to mention the most applied, the main important, but there are many other kinds of certification that the tanner sector can apply. So please, if you want to have technical details, please ask me writing.
Yeah. I think this is the most common question, Sabrina. Now the people, the brand, and the young designer, they want to know what kind of certification are minimum, let's say, to start with. And I think you already give a lot of inside today on what eCheck can certify, but also what is the ISO certification. I don't know if you want to add something more on the, what is the basic to start with. But
I tried to cover every topics, and for sure when a brand or a manufacturer want to qualify the supply chain, the main topic are environment, health and safety, social and traceability issues. So you always have this kind of topics in qualification schemes from each brand. And I told you our experience, our numbers, and our scheme of certification related to these three areas, because they are always requested by the supply chain.
That's great. I think that's all, Sabrina. If you don't want to add anything for everybody that follow us, thanks a lot for following us to make us the questions. That was very, very helpful. And thanks, Sabrina from eCheck, to tell us what eCheck is doing. If you want to know more about eCheck, guys, goes into the website. You can see all the tanneries, all the brands that apply to eCheck and are certified by eCheck. You can find it there. And go again in the sustainability talk of Linea Pelle to see back the recording of it. And thanks to everybody, and thanks also
to Linea Pelle. Thank you very much to all of you. Thank you.
See you next time.
See you.
Bye.